The RB26 engine of the Nissan GT-R is one of the best in the world, and today we'll see why it is literally a true Godzilla. The engine was designed in the 1980s and is a 2.6-liter inline six-cylinder. This type of configuration is widely used because its second-order alternative masses are perfectly canceled, leading to a vibration-free engine, especially if it revs very high at 8,000 RPM. The diameter of the piston is 86 millimeters, and they have 73.3 millimeters of stroke. This gives a super square engine. This means that pistons move relatively slower, reducing friction against the cylinder wall and resulting in less loss as well as lower temperature. In this animation, you can see a comparison of three engines turning at the same RPM, but the pistons have different speeds. As you may see, the right piston moves slower. This means more crankshaft RPM can be achieved. Higher RPM increases horsepower because more quantity of combustion occurs. The use of the cylinder in the same time is increased. However, these engines tend to have slightly less torque since the air has less time to enter the cylinder, which results in weaker explosions. Although we must not forget that there are two twin turbos that compensate for this problem. Two smaller turbos were added to fit them easier under the hood. A single large turbo would have had a big diameter. Added to the pipes of the exhaust manifold would end up having different lengths due to lack of space. The two small turbos have less mass, less turbo lag, and are simply more comfortable saving space. Something to highlight was that it had ceramic bearings, being the best option for that time. This group of Garrett turbines were factory limited to 10 PSI or 0.7 bar. As for the block, which is very resistant, it's a closed deck of cast iron. As you can see, it only has the holes for the cylinder head bolts, the water channels, and the oil passages. An open block is when the cylinders are surrounded by water channels. The closed block turns out to be very strong, and that in the future it will support a very high power increase searched by turners. 1,000 horsepower configurations have been achieved. The crankshaft and connecting rods are made of forged steel. The pistons are made of aluminum and are cooled by an oil shot. Instead of using the simple spray method, the pistons have an internal toroid where the oil circulates, being more effective and keeping the pistons up to 140 degrees Fahrenheit, lower than the conventional method. Looking at the pistons, we can see the inlet port and the outlet port. Something that was used at the time was the bump on the pistons to increase compression and respect the shape of the combustion chamber, although today this would not be used since a hemispherical chamber and a lighter piston with less material are preferred. Let me just take advantage of this part to remind you to leave your like or a super thanks. Now, let's continue with the video. The camshafts are driven by belts since, although they have less duration compared to a chain, the belt is more efficient and lighter, using less horsepower to roll. The cam system is double and it commands the valves directly through the fixed tappets regulated by internal shims. The internal shims make the job of regulating valves more difficult, but this prevents the valves from blowing away the shim by high RPM. The shape of the combustion chamber is pent roof. Here we can easily see the five roofs, and it also has two small squish areas so that the fuel combustion occurs right in the center where the spark plug is located. Exhaust valves are sodium-filled for heat dissipation. Power for ignition under turbo pressure is provided by individual coils mounted on the same spark plug. Something rarely seen for the time and worthy of a modern engine. The cylinder head is made of aluminum, ideal for quickly extracting heat and reducing the weight of the vehicle, especially in the upper part, which alters the center of gravity. The ports are optimized for high airflow and do not have any manufacturing defects. The head is linked to individual throttle bodies or ITBs. This gives minimal lag in throttle response and great power. The six injectors are located in this part, being 440cc and operating sequentially, a true multi-point injection. And above these, there's a skinny but long tank. Since individual throttle bodies are used, the six vacuums must be linked to have a smooth injection reference. Its compression ratio is somewhat low for today, but spicy for a late 80s turbo engine, being 8.5 to 1. With all this, the Nissan RB26 engine declared 276 horsepower. But it is well known that in reality, it had 323 horsepower. The false declaration of power was a product of an agreement between Japanese brands not to exceed 276 horsepower. However, the Nissan Skyline GTR Nismo came prepared for a quick turbo boost of 4 PSI with a simple modification to its line-painted hose. By removing a simple internal restriction in the hose, the RB26 engine went from 323 to 360 horsepower. All this without even going to a workshop or remapping the engine, where in case of doing it, the power would increase even more. It is known for sure that these Nissan engines were factory internals, and larger turbos can exceed 600 horsepower, since in reality, the engine was designed for racing and then reduced in power to be within the 276 horsepower previously established limit. There are tuners that manage to fit a single large turbo, being the best option for maximum power. Thinking about it, it can be said that this engine, designed nearly 40 years ago, is still giving headaches to newer engines, such as the BMW N54, which is 400cc larger, 3 liters, with a compression ratio of 10 to 1, and getting 302 horsepower, 21 less than the GTR. The Nissan GTR R33 also became the first stock car lowering 8 minutes at Nürburgring, leaving the previous winner 20 seconds behind. The RB26 engine was installed in 3 generations of GTR, the R32, the R33, which was said to be slightly slower due to its heavier weight, and the R34. It should be noted that in the early years, the engine could only rev up to 7,500 RPM and was prone to damage by lack of lubrication at the crankshaft. The second generation brought a more powerful oil pump, improved cams, and a revision in the crankshaft, which allowed reaching 8,000 RPMs without risks. As said at the beginning, this engine was designed in 1980 and was born from the RB20, an engine with only 2 liters of displacement that failed to win the racing championship that was led by the Ford Sierra. Nissan took this engine and expanded it to 2.4 liters, appearing the RB24. The Nissan all-wheel drive system called ATESA was installed. This intelligent traction, controlled by an advanced 16-bit computer from the 80s, kept the rotation of the 4 tires under control at a level never seen before. To this was added the rear steering system. That is, the 4 wheels of the car turned, obtaining a higher level of driving with better steer. Despite this, these systems increased the weight of the GTR, and the power produced by the RB24 seemed to be not enough. Finally, the size of the engine increased even more to the RB26. Its name comes from RB for 6 cylinders in line, 26 because it's 2.6 liters, D by DOHC, dual overhead camshaft. The E stands for electronic fuel injection, and TT because it has 2 turbos. This is Repairman 22, and if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave your like. Also, write a comment and share it with your friends. See you next time.